Welcome back, everyone. This is day 22 of our grow, Saturday, the 16th of May, 2020. We have our starters from last week. So we're gonna go ahead and thin these out and get these in some weak nutrient solution. We will also check out our mammoth basil and see how that's coming along. Check out our salad mix. We'll put our starters from day 8 in some full nutrient and we'll load the rack. So the loading the rack will be a little bit different than I had planned originally in my schedule, and we'll cover that later. So we'll have a little bit of controversy. Woo. But let's get started. Get these thinned out. They're looking really good. Very happy with it. I don't think I told you, but I actually switched to the 2020 seeds for these romaines. So everything is looking really nice. Now we got our day 15 starters all thinned out. Put a little bit of nutrient in from my jug and put in a little pH down. Got it down to the very low sixes for pH. So I think we are good with that. And you may remember from day 1, just checking, this is our mammoth basil. As I said, I've never grown mammoth basil before. It doesn't seem to grow like Genovese or an Italian large leaf. I'm accustomed to the Italian large leaf. But this grows more, almost like a leafy lettuce, it looks like, from what I've seen in pictures. But we'll figure that out. But I'm going to go ahead and thin this down now. And it's already in full nutrient. So I've thinned down the mammoth basil. There were 4 growing. I've thinned it down to 2. So next week I'll take another look at it and then I'll eliminate another one. But I just want to see which one is the strongest. One has got a little bit of a legginess there to it. One of it's kind of compact, so yeah, no harm in letting them both go for another week. As I said, I've never grown this variety before, so just take it as it comes. And this is our salad mix from day 8. And in this we had, prize leaf lettuce, Grand Rapids leaf, and some Lola Rosa. And it looks like most of what came up, at least from first impressions, is the prize. There might be another variety that came in. As I said, these were 2018 seeds. I think I only got 2 plants there, 1 there, and I'd say at least 3, if not 4 there. So we're just gonna let them keep going, and then you'll be able to see as time goes how it becomes these great little clusters. So they're fantastic. And these are the starters from day 8. Looking pretty good. Not much root on that. Or on that. There we go. Some nice root structure there. So these are ready for some full nutrient. I'll go get these loaded up. And here are the 5 starters from day 8, all loaded up, labeled up, and ready to go on the rack. Last thing we have is to start 5 new romaines. Here we have our 5 new romaine starters. Everything is ready to go on back on the shelf. So my original plan was to have all the items go on the bottom shelf today, which would be 2 starter buckets, 10 of the single lettuce buckets, and then 1 extra item. But what we have is 2 extra items, so we have 14 buckets. And I know from growing in the past that 14 buckets on 1 shelf makes the items on the corners get a little bit reachy, and I just don't like that. So although I do prefer to have the lettuce the first 4 weeks of growing being on the bottom shelf, which saves me money, and it also helps me do the rotation where I can get up to 5 head of lettuce a week plus a little bit extra, we're going to step outside of normal operating procedures and we're going to put the 5 lettuce from day one on the center shelf under the adjustable height light, and we'll also do the salad mix as well. We have our 5 lettuce from day one along with our salad mix. The way I arrange these are the buckets on the edge will be 11 spaces from the side, and there will be 4 spaces in between. If I want to set it and forget it, I will place the buckets approximately 1.5 inches away from that center bar. Generally, when I grow, I do a set it and forget it, and I leave the light in a fixed position. But if you recall from the video where I did the setup, we have this light on some strings so we can lower the light down, and I will do that, bringing the light down to a position approximately 9 inches above canopy, and we'll bring all these buckets in towards the center line. I've lowered the light, so the light to the top of the canopy, if you want to call it a canopy at this point, is roughly 9 inches, which lowers it down, about 4 inches or so from its fixed position. And then I moved all the buckets in so they're touching that center line. And then as these continue to grow, we'll slowly raise the light position up and we'll move the buckets out. When the buckets are about 1.5 inches away from that center bar, the spacing is approximately 10.5 inches on center, and that gives us lots of good airflow around it. And as we'll see in the video in 2 weeks, we'll do that on the top shelf where we will put it all in a fixed position, we'll set it and forget it. For the bottom shelf, we have our individual buckets from our day 8. We have our starter bucket from day 15, the ones we just started today, day 22, and over here in the corner we have our mammoth basil. So not too much exciting happening today other than moving up the lettuce to the center shelf. So I think it'll give us a little bit of time to see what it's like if you wanted to micromanage light positions and bucket positions and see how it affects the growth. As I said, generally I just prefer to set it and forget it, but figure I'll give you a little variety. Still really excited, glad you have come along for the journey, and I will catch you next time.